Chairperson Mrs. Malvika Rai, Director Professor Mukherjee, Dean Dr. Mishra, members of the faculty, graduating students, Sri Sukhvir Singh Ji, Sri Gupta Ji, Sri Sharma Ji, ladies and gentlemen, I'm indeed very happy to be here with you this afternoon on the occasion of the first convocation for award of postgraduate diploma in management in this institute. In a short span of time, this institute has created a niche for itself in the field of management education in India. I would like to congratulate each one of the young graduates. You're going to enter a new exciting world of business opportunities, a world which is changing very rapidly. These are extraordinary times, and you should be prepared to face the challenges of change. Those of you who are able to anticipate the change and exploit it will be more successful. We in India should have the ambition of leading from the front and make things happen on our own terms. India is fast emerging as a global economic power in the 21st century. China and India have emerged as dramatic, dynamic competitors in last one decade. India's economy has been growing at the rate of 8% annually for the last couple of years, and a large number of foreign investors are making a beeline for investment in Indian territory. The famous Goldman Sachs report predicts that India, along with China and the US, will be the three top economies of the world by the year 2050. According to the economist Jeffrey Sachs, this could happen sooner than 2050. Government of India has also taken many initiatives for promoting economic growth and infrastructure development. Bharat Nirman, an infrastructure development program for unleashing the process of growth in rural areas, Jawaharlal Nehru National Urban Renewal Mission for holistic development of infrastructure and basic services in an integrated manner in urban areas, liberalized foreign direct investment norms and permitting FDI in new areas under automatic route, simplification of procedures and the special economic zones will give major boost to the infrastructure development and economic activities in the country. New governance reforms, Right to Information Act, and more autonomy and accountability to public sector will have far-reaching implications in improving efficiency and effectiveness in all sectors. This will create new opportunities for the technical and management professionals. For many of you, this day will be an extremely happy one. You are graduating from one of the finest management institutes in the country with a splendid future in front of you. When you reach a certain stature in life, India should have eliminated poverty and be nudging into the ranks of the middle-income countries. Some of you will have climbed your way to the top of Fortune 500 companies, while others will have created them. Some will be charismatic political leaders, while others will choose to dedicate their lives in helping others through social work. In whatever you do, you will face all challenges. After all, this is what makes life exciting. And I'm sure you have been trained here to overcome them. You as management graduates have many choices of choosing what kind of work you will do and how you will do it. Make full use of that choice. As fresh graduates, you will be extremely eager to climb the corporate ladder, to be vice president in 5 years and a CEO in 10. Are these the right objectives? The fact is, when young, we think we will be happy if we achieve a lot. We all want fame and fortune and as rapidly as possible. Yet, as the Bhagavad Gita tells us, The goal itself is of limited utility. It is the process that matters. If you do not enjoy the job that you are doing, if you do not feel you are a productive and contributing member of society, rapid promotion or increasing fame will simply not be enough compensation. If you do not like going to work every day, the fact that you are driven to it in the best car of the world is not going to make it any more pleasant. My advice to you will be to reach out and explore. Try different things. Be unconventional. You will undoubtedly hit dead ends. However, you also are more likely to reach your vocation in life, the career that was made for you. And when you work with all the passion in your heart, you will find that not only does success come as a matter of course, but also it is incidental because work itself is its own fulfillment. You have to adopt a proactive approach. Besides your main role in the corporate world, you should strive to improve the quality of life of the poor in the rural and the urban areas of our country. Touch the lives of the common man for uplifting the quality of life. It is in these areas where young, competent minds can play a strategic role. There is a need for students to emulate a sense of vision to withstand the competition. You should never lose your intellectual curiosity and should learn from everything that you do. Not only concentrate on your success, but help make people successful, and they will in turn help you succeed in whatever you pursue. And above all of us must try to be good human beings. Finally, I would like to congratulate the director and the faculty of the IILM. Let IILM assume the reputation of becoming well known not only for capturing and nurturing talent, but also building innovative capacity in this talent to create world-class products, processes and services that will take the nation to great heights. I wish the IILM family the very best in its journey to excellence. And finally, my best wishes to your bright futures. Thank you.